Welcome back to the channel. My name is Sydney. For those of you who don't know me, I am a first year resident doing a transitional year residency out just outside of Tampa after not matching, which if you are following me and have seen my videos, you know that I did not match into OBGYN last year. So I moved from Jacksonville where I was doing my rotations to now I am in Tampa for my first year of residency, like I said, doing a transitional year. So that kind of sums that up. Also, I just want to apologize. Residency, the time has been flying and I did not realize it's been since March, since I've actually posted. So I've filmed a couple different like vlogs and just didn't edit them. So I never posted them, but I do have clips from the first week of residency and I want to just put those in, even though that's from July, because a lot of people have been asking me how things have been going. And I actually had an interview last week where one of the people interviewing me said that she watched my YouTube videos and she was like, the last video you posted like was the story about you not matching. She was like, I think people want a happy ending. And so I was like, oh, you're right. You know, I should get on here and just say how much of a blessing this transitional year has been. Of course, it's going to be hard and, you know, it's residency. But I just want to say that I could have been anywhere in the country. I could have been without a job. But with a job, I could have been anywhere in the country once I went through the SOAP last year. And so for me to be in a position where I'm at a place that is supportive and really wants the best for me and wants me to match into whatever specialty I want to match in, they're doing everything they can to help me. They're making phone calls, sending emails. And so I just could have been in a place that wasn't like that. And it's not like that at all. I have, you know, a lot of my co-residents I know from LECOM, which is really nice too. I've met a lot of great people. I've had really, really good mentors and I've had, you know, great seniors that I've worked with. So I just want to say that time is flying. I'm learning a lot. It's, like I said, truly just been a blessing and I'm just super grateful because, like I said, I was sitting in this position in March worried if I was even going to have a job. And so I think my perspective has just changed. And I shared this with the person interviewing me, but I said, I heard this from someone a couple weeks ago and they said, when you change the way you look at things, things you look at begin to change. And that just couldn't be more true. Perspective is everything. And I, you know, we'll just want to say thank you to my friends and family, and especially my fiance, who's really just changed my attitude about a lot of things. He's just so big on growth, development, and mindset. And I've taken on a lot of that just by listening to his podcast and just being around him. And it's just helped me be grateful for what I have, not spend time in the past and not spend too much time in the future, going with the flow of things and just learning from every opportunity. I think a lot of times, especially us in medicine, we tend to hyper focus on something that has happened, like a mistake we've made or a test score or not matching, whatever the case may be. I feel like we just hyper focus on things like that because we in medicine think if we make one mistake, it's detrimental to our entire career. And I'm not saying that that's not the case sometimes, but everything happens for a reason. And I wouldn't be in this position if it wasn't, you know, for a reason. And I just have faith that something bigger is in the works and I just have to, you know, enjoy the process. So I just wanted to jump on and say that because I, you know, haven't posted in a while and these videos are super random because they're from July. So these are going to be the first days of, I think I ended up filming the first 3 days of my residency, but they're like, the filming is a disaster because I honestly forgot I was filming, but it at least shows kind of what a day is like and how I felt going into my first day. I don't have an ending, so I'm going to have to jump back on and do a little ending, but it's only going to be like 8 minutes or so. And then I'm going to post another video probably in a couple days from now about my universal trip because my family came down. So anyways, things have been going great. Thank you to everyone who's reached out and left comments on my YouTube. I have not even been on my YouTube channel in months. Just going through applications and interviews, it's just been difficult, but I, you know, things have kind of calmed down now with interviews. And like I said, the applications have already been sent. And so I'm not really kind of working on that stuff anymore. So I have some time on my hands. But thank you guys so much for watching. Sorry for rambling. I hope you guys enjoy these few little clips I have from residency and I will try my best to update you guys some more and kind of give you an insight to what it's like to be a resident. Enjoy. morning, guys. I don't have much time because I'm at a red light. I just wanted to say welcome back to the channel. Today is my first day of residency. I say that with a lot of energy because I'm just trying to convince myself I have that much energy this morning. But okay, light is green. I'll catch up with you in a bit. So I have to be at the hospital at 5:30 today. I have about a 30-minute commute, but it can range anywhere from 30 to like 45 minutes. So I got up at 3:50, left by like 4:40, and you know, just to give myself extra time and stuff. And I am starting on ward, so inpatient internal medicine, and we will be paired up with the other interns, so the other internal medicine interns, and have a senior, but I'm not really sure kind of how it works until I get there. And obviously I can't film in the hospital and really show too much, but I just wanted to kind of document my side and, you know, getting through this. So yeah, I will catch up with you guys in a little bit. I totally forgot to film after I left the hospital yesterday, so I'm just gonna give you guys a quick rundown kind of on how the day went yesterday. So today is day two of residency. I don't even know how I am so awake this morning. But so yesterday I got to the hospital around like 5:15, and I have like a 30-minute commute. In the mornings it's like 25 minutes. It's like even less than that sometimes, but on the way home it's like 45 minutes. So I just leave early, you know, just in case. I got there around then, met with my senior. I had never met them. So we have a senior resident, we have two interns and a medical student, and then our attending. So that's our little team, and each team is kind of made up of different people. And so there's multiple teams because the internal medicine residency is huge. So I get in there, we meet our senior, we kind of go through like the EMR system together and how we pick patients, and they assigned us some patients. We looked over their charts in the morning. So basically kind of how the mornings go on the weekdays for our program is Mondays and Fridays, there is a morning report at 8 a.m. from 8 to 9. And then also every day, Monday through Friday, there's noon lecture or like a didactics. So you kind of have to like round in between those and like finish your notes and see your patients for the morning at least. So you get there at like 5:30, let's just say 5:30. You go see your patients and you start your notes from like 5:30 to 7-ish. And then you talk with your senior, you kind of get your stuff together. You go to morning report if it's a Monday or Friday. If it's not, you have extra time to do your notes, put in orders, go see more patients, whatever you need to do. And then we round with our attending at 9 a.m. So rounding on internal medicine is about like an hour and a half. So you round like 9 to 10:30-ish. You go finish your notes and orders from whatever you need to add from rounds or whatever you need to add from the morning. And then you take that time until noon conference. And then after that, you kind of finish your notes. So then the other kicker is that in my program, and I think a lot of programs, is kind of you rotate call throughout the day between the groups. So at this program, there's 6 hospitalist groups, internal medicine groups, made up of like residents and an attending. And you switch. So you take a 2-hour call window. So it's either 8 to 10, 10 to 12, 12 to 2, 2 to 4, or late call 4 to 6. And that just means that those hours you are accepting the new admitting patients if there's patients that come in. That way each group kind of doesn't get bombarded with a bunch of patients at once, you know, more than the other group. And so that's kind of how the days work. I know that was a lot and kind of confusing, but I just wanted to get on here before I have to go inside. Filming in residency is really hard. I don't have an extra hour to spare to even like think about editing a video, let alone like remembering to actually video. So I just want to apologize for that, but I am on my 4th day. So I started on Friday, July 1st, worked Friday, Saturday, Sunday. And then one of us had to take an off day because we take an off day once a week on this, internal medicine rotation. So one of us had to take an off day, and I just asked for it since it was Dom's birthday on Sunday and I couldn't be with him. So I was like, okay, well, I'll take Monday. So I had the day off yesterday. It was amazing. Slept in. Didn't wake up at 3:45, so it was really nice. But yeah, so I just got back to the hospital. It is Tuesday, so the day after July 4th. And my senior is not on our service with us today. So usually it's, like I said, 2 interns, a senior, and an attending. That's how it is for us. But today our senior's not with us, so we are taking over his patients. I'm gonna go in here and review these charts and then try to go see all these patients before we round at 9 a.m. Hopefully I can sit down and discuss more about like what we actually do and what it's actually like in residency now. But I just want to keep getting on here and just at least getting snippets. But okay guys, I'll talk to you soon. If you made it through those three very painful and unorganized videos, three or four videos from residency, I just want to say thank you so much for watching. I promise that I have more footage that I will either upload or I will film new footage. But seriously, thank you guys for being so supportive and watching, and I will see you guys on the next one. Bye.